In this example, we are given that in figure, switch S is closed at t equals to 0. We are required to find charge on capacitor as a function of time. Here we are given that the inductor is active with the initial current I naught in it. So here we can see the total energy of circuit at the initial moment is half L I naught square. And when the whole energy will be converted into electrostatic energy of capacitor, the charge in capacitor will be maximum. Here we can write if Q naught is the maximum charge on capacitor, which can also be written as charge amplitude, because we know in case of LC oscillation, charge oscillates about its neutral position on both sides with the maximum charges. So here if Q naught is the maximum charge on capacitor, we use half L I naught square should be equals to Q naught square by 2C. And on simplifying here, you can see the value of maximum charge or charge amplitude on capacitor can be written as root of LC multiplied by I naught. Now, this is the maximum charge about with which the charge on capacitor oscillates, because when the current is continued, it will deposit a charge plus Q and minus Q over here, and it will further oscillate. So, here we can write charge on capacitor as a function of time, Q can be given by the general simple harmonic motion relation, that is Q naught sine of omega t plus alpha. And here we know the value of omega, we can directly use 1 by root of LC, that is the standard for a given LC oscillation. And here we can write at t equals to 0, charge on capacitor was 0. This implies on substituting the values, we are getting alpha is equals to 0, because the capacitor is starting its charge from mean position. So we can write the charge as a function of time as Q naught, which we can write as root of LC I naught sine of omega t alpha, we can take as 0. So this will be t by root LC. This will be the answer to this problem, that is charge on capacitor as a function of time.